The lunar cycle is about 29 days, and so is the average menstrual cycle. Ish. Coincidence? People have been making the connection between the moon's phases and the menstrual cycle for centuries. And as it turns out, those people had more solid rationale for connecting periods with the moon than you'd think. But the weirdest part is that in terms of stuff controlling human periods, we may have been looking at the wrong thing in the sky all along. Let's start with a flashback to health class and go over what a menstrual cycle is. The menstrual cycle is the process that gets your body ready to possibly become pregnant. And in humans, the whole thing is about a month long. The cycle starts on day one of your period, when the uterine lining starts to shed. This is the menses phase, which generally lasts 3 to 7 days and overlaps with the follicular phase. The follicular phase goes from the start of your period until one of your ovaries pops out a new egg cell, usually about 10 to 14 days after the beginning of your last period. This marks the beginning of the luteal phase, which is when that little egg cell you made travels down the ovarian tube, aka the fallopian tube, and into the uterus. And if that egg wasn't fertilized, then a change in hormone levels will trigger your next period and the whole thing starts all over again. Since this all happens more or less monthly, maybe it's not surprising that it's been coupled with the other mostly monthly cycle out in nature, the lunar month. That's about the amount of time it takes to go from one full moon to the next, which is 29 and a half days. And the idea that these two cycles are linked is so old that our word for both of them comes from the Indo-European root word meh, which means to measure. The Greek philosopher Aristotle believed that the menses occur during the waning of the moon because that time of the month is colder and more humid, which, okay, I guess. But this connection isn't just a European thing. Versions of this also show up in the belief systems of indigenous groups from Tanzania, the Central African Republic, Mexico, US, Canada, you get the idea. And if all these people around the world have made that connection, could they all really be wrong? Yes, almost definitely. There's been a lot of research into whether the moon really does have a say over when Aunt Flo comes to visit, and the outlook isn't great. For starters, the average cycle length actually varies person to person because the clinically normal range can be anywhere from 24 to 38 days. And cycle length can also vary for an individual too. A 2006 paper found that about 42% of people's cycles varied by more than 7 days in a single year. Okay, so maybe not everyone is synced up to the moon, but like, is anyone? To answer that, we need to look at all the people with 4-ish week cycles and see if their cycles line up with any of the phases of the moon. And yeah, people have done a lot of studies about this.
Thanks to Trainwell for supporting this SciShow video. We all know exercise is good for us, but it can be hard to stay consistent, especially when you're trying something new or you get injured. That's why exercising with another person's support can be a game changer. The expert personal trainers at Trainwell fill that role. They provide that human connection that makes exercise feel more doable. When you take the fitness quiz, you answer a few questions about your unique situation and get paired with your trainer picked just for you. Then you can video chat with them and get a personalized workout program that you can adapt as you improve. Trainwell gives you the professional guidance of a trainer with the flexibility and functionality of a Forbes top-ranked app. The Trainwell app allows you to get those workouts in whenever and wherever it works for you so that fitness can be a seamless part of your life. To get 14 days free with your own personal trainer, go to go.trainwell.net/scishow or click the link down in the description.
A few of the really old studies from the last century found tentative correlations, but the more recent, longer studies with more participants really don't. One large-scale analysis in 2016 by a period tracking app called Clue found that across the 1.5 million users and 7.5 million menstrual cycles they looked at, there was no correlation at all between lunar cycle and period starting. So we have a pretty huge data set to show that people's periods don't line up with any particular phases of the moon, and they happen at pretty much any time of the month. Between that and the amount of variation in cycle length, there's not really any evidence backing up any sort of connection between the moon and human reproduction. Sorry to burst anyone's bubble. But weirdly enough, there are some animals whose reproductive cycles do line up with the moon. For instance, some studies have shown that sea urchin gonads get larger under the full moon, but they're basically non-existent under the new moon. And this matters because we love to eat those gonads, which you've probably seen on a sushi menu as uni. And if you didn't know what that was until just now, well, I hope I didn't ruin it for you because they're still delicious. Anyway, sea urchin fishers would describe the urchins as being full at the full moon and empty at the new moon, and would specifically only gather them when they knew they'd be full. And it's not just urchins. Some corals spawn en masse on a particular night, a few nights after the full moon. We think they can time it so well based on the amount of moonlight they're exposed to, thanks to specialized photosensitive molecules in their tissue. Spawning all at once like this means they've got better odds of sperm and egg joining up, so it works out pretty well that they have nature's biggest nightlight telling them all when to go. Some marine zooplankton also time their mating by the moon's phases, mating at both the new and the full moon. Now, you may have noticed a trend here. These are all marine animals. Researchers think that these animals might be staying synced up to the lunar calendar by using the changing tides, or maybe even reacting to the brighter moonlight under a full moon. And since humans have lived oceanside for a very long time, it's not a huge leap to think we've been paying attention to what we see going on in the water, especially when it has to do with what goes on our dinner plates. So part of this moon periods connection might come from people's observations of reproduction in the natural world, especially when those people were depending on marine food sources and therefore paying extra attention to these cycles. And while the evidence is pretty clear that the moon doesn't influence human menstruation, there's growing evidence that the sun actually plays a role. A study of periods in a Russian city showed that the amount of sunlight a person sees could affect how long their period will be. Getting exposed to more sunlight just before they ovulated meant that they'd have a shorter period relative to when they're exposed to less light. More sunshine led to people's menstrual cycles being about a day shorter during summertime, and the correlation was specific to sunlight, not temperature or any other weather variables. Other studies have suggested that increased exposure to artificial light could shorten menstrual cycles too. So artificial light appears to suppress how much melatonin we make, and it turns out that melatonin could be involved in regulating some period-related hormones. And essentially, the suggestion is that more light means less melatonin, which means shorter periods. So there may well be a connection between what's happening in the sky and what happens with people's menstrual cycles. It's just not the one we've been fixated on for centuries. And even though our ancestors were totally wrong when they tried to connect the moon's phases to their time of the month, now you can see there was a bit more logic behind that connection than you might think. I hope we've shed a little moonlight on the topic.